Hello guys, Greer438 here. Welcome to another episode of Let's Play Metal Arms Glitch in the System. In the last episode, we showed a lot of fucking multiplayer maps. Sorry for the random F word thrown in there. Couldn't really find out what I was saying for some reason. But in this episode, I have two more multiplayer maps to show you. We'll see what else we can get to. So yeah, we're going to the Coliseum. This is actually a multiplayer map, and it's completely set up like the first challenge, which was 15 minutes. Which is a new TV show, guys. It's basically 1/4 of what you'd see in 16 minutes. And what you get. You're not pulling me in. So this stage doesn't really have a lot to it. You can actually screw your opponents over by shooting the targets, and then you kill them. Oh, no, what that says. Well, you can actually go into Corrosive's deck here. There's actually a rock that lets you do it. Or some kind of stone thing. You can go up here. Oh no, you can't actually go into the thing itself, but you can definitely go on top of it. And there's one enemy here, there's a guard. Nah. Oh, apparently we can get him all the way from down there. Hacks, guys, hacks. Oh, we'll just run around with this guy. So yeah. Let's see, we'll shoot this thing, cause why not? And shoot that thing, cause why not? Yeah, I think it's broken. If you get caught in it, you die. Oh, whoa. Huh. What? I couldn't move, guys. That was whack, yo. It, like, pulled me. Like, the tractor beam, like, pulled me there and, like went over here. And, like, I couldn't move for a couple seconds. Oh, so you can go into the bleachers. Wait, can you? No, you can't, never mind. But the bleachers are completely empty. Huh. Interesting. Alright. There's shield there, some mega bombs. There's a nice place to hide here, actually.
Great patrol, but
you know? Anyway, though, I think we showed off enough of this level. So now it's time to actually go to the last multiplayer level. Now for this, oh yeah, I must mention I am actually on a different profile. I'm on my practice file because on my file Creator438, which is my Let's Play file, I didn't actually get all secret chips, so I couldn't access all the maps. What I'm actually going to do for this one is I need to be in a custom game that turns off all vehicles. As you can see, we have nothing changed except for one thing. Only vehicles are none. For what I'm going to show, you must have a custom game made where there are no vehicles in the level at all. We're going to Corrosive City. So this is the last adventure. Or this is, I almost said adventure map. This is the last multiplayer map. I have bots on, by the way. But anyway, though, if you go up here, oh shit. Oh, there's Titan there too, oh shit. I did this for a reason, guys, just trust me. You don't have to do this, but I chose to. If you go up there, go up here. Go all the way up here. Take this jump up here. You see a console. Hey, it's Dr. Exavolt. If you do all this after getting all of the secret and speed chips in the game, it can be on any difficulty. Not only do you unlock this map as a reward, but if you do all that and turn off all vehicles in the level, guess what your reward is? You get to play as General Corrosive in multiplayer. He controls the exact same way. However, this time he actually isn't invincible. You play as the Broken One in the final level. Final battle. So he actually is possible to kill. The reason I turned on the bots and such is so that I would fight them while I played Corrosive. But yeah, it's really cool that you get to play Corrosive. Remember, you can only do this if you get all the speed and secret chips. It's not just unlock this map, because you can technically unlock this map before you get all the speed chips and all the secret chips, but you have to, like, the console won't work if you just come on here without all the secret chips and all the speed chips. So yeah, I did this on easy because I just couldn't do it on normal. I was lucky enough to ever do it at all. Because I wanted the experience of playing as General Corrosive. For some reason, this only works if you have vehicles off in a custom game. I don't know why they did that. It threw me off the first time that I had to watch a video on it. So, yeah. But, yeah. It's a very cool thing to do, guys. Like, I'm not even kidding. And the bots will always respawn. Of course, he is not invincible this time, so he is actually possible to kill. So, if you guys want to send in videos, like, having one guy get in the console and fighting General Corrosive, like, teaming him, essentially. I'd love to see those two along with any predator battles. Because there are two predators in that one level with the drill. Whoa, shit. Oh, they blew off my lower arm. In the game, of course. So yeah, this is honestly the coolest multiplayer level just for this reason. And if you unlock, and honestly, if you get this, then you're greatly rewarded with a lot of friends, with a lot of multiplayer fun with your friends, or brothers, or sisters, or whoever the hell you want to play multiplayer with, and whoever the hell wants to play with you. Oh shit, huh. Yeah, you will actually degrade just like the final boss version of General Corrosive. And you will die the same way too. As you can see, these bots are having a lot easier time taking General Corrosive down than I did. I don't actually know if there's a way you can jump. Okay, as you can see, we're dying now in the game. Don't trust what is falling. And you fall all the way down here. And once you kill him, his corpse disappears. Or I mean his body, I guess you'd say. Anyway, I think we're done for now. So yeah. Alright guys, so that's all the multiplayer levels. But it's not done yet. There's another thing that I want to show you guys. Which you get after you complete the main story mode. As you can see, we can start our adventure again. We can't continue our adventure because there's no adventure to continue, of course. But as you can see, this thing right here that was grayed out before that we could not view until we beat the game. It's the original concept movie. So let's enter it. 2 weeks before E3 2001, Swing Ape Studios needed a way to both showcase its technology and sell the concept of Metal Arms to potential publishers. What we came up with is the following short demo movie captured from our 3D engine. That, ladies and gentlemen, was the original concept movie for Metal Arms Go to the System. Please do not smite me at Activision or Blizzard or whoever the hell owns this game at the moment for showing that. Because it's a very interesting movie. It's basically, from what it implies, it is what they showed off at E3 2001 to basically, like, get publishers for Metal Arms Go to the System, because at the time they were still like making the game, and they were like Swing Ape Studios was trying to get people to buy it, and yeah, that was basically the thing with that. So yeah. That was like the. I think they showed that off on like their E3 booths or something. Like, I'm pretty sure they have like a booth set up. And like they showed that on a computer or something. I don't know how it worked out. I don't think they showed it during any press conference. I'm really not sure how it all worked out. So yeah. However, aside from other movies, there are actually two things that I have not shown in the main story, and what those things are is like actually like movies that basically tell you you've lost, GG. There are two movies that I have to show you. There is the movie for... So basically, there's a movie that plays like when Droid Town is taken over in Clean Up and Unwelcome Home, which are both Droid Town levels. And basically, the deal there is that, like, if you do a thing, like, Colonel Alloy will tell you that you can't leave the battlefield at a certain point in both levels, because he says the innocent droids are harmed and you need to go back and save them. But if you actually go far enough into the level, he will stop you, and he says that we've suffered too many droid casualties, and that, like, the cause for fighting is lost, and then you lose the level, and it plays a little, video. So I will show you what that is. There's also another one in the Zombie Bot King level, and, like I mentioned, you're actually on a timer in that level, that they don't actually show you, but you are on a timer. And what happens is, if you don't beat Zombie Bot King in time, the Moser will actually die. So I'm going to show both of those off right now. So I'll see you when I get to that first movie.
You can't leave the battle glitch! Innocent droids are being slaughtered! Get back there or we're doomed! Glitch, we've suffered too many droid casualties. The cause is lost.
Now, awkwardly enough, that same cutscene will play on Unwelcome Home, as I mentioned. But the weird thing about that is, first of all, it's all red mills. And in Unwelcome Home, if I remember correctly, there's only one red mill, if not two. But I'm pretty sure there's only one red mill. There are definitely not more than... There's definitely not more than, like, one or two red mills in that level. So, it uses the same cutscene, and in that level it's also night. But I'm pretty sure in this level... Is it day in this? Yeah, it's daytime. So, it really makes you wonder why they'd use the same cutscene. Because it doesn't really make sense. Like, just the context of what's going on. Well, not like the context. It's kind of the same. It's basically the same idea, but, like, I mean, I don't know. It's just like, because there's a completely different time of day, and there are more red mills than there should be, which is just awkward. It's not awkward, but it's different. Because they're mostly like troopers and guards in that level. There's a couple like regular grunts and such. But like nothing too significant really. So yeah. That just always kind of puzzled me ever since I knew about that. So yeah. I will see you guys in the Zombie Bot King level for the next video, or for the next little, like, clip, where it shows Moser getting killed. I've only seen that one, like, once, I'm pretty sure. I vaguely remember, like, what it's like, so, yeah. I'll see you guys then. Shit. As you can see from the mission objective thing, the thing that kills, that would kill Moser is called the giant bot chipper. I don't know why they gave that an official name, but I don't know. So yeah, that is the deal with that, basically. So yeah, the thing kills Moser and he gets wrecked. If you take too long, then that happens. I don't know exactly how long it takes for Moser to get killed by that thing. Which, I mean, the giant bot chipper, I should call it. But, yeah. That's basically what will happen if you run out of time. It wrecks Moser and you lose the level. And you have to start over. So, that's pretty much everything in this game. There's some speed chips I'll never get, unless you guys really want me to, by popular demand, get all secret chips. But unless you guys say that you want me to do that, I'm not going to do it, because secret chips, I mean, if you know what they are, they're not... I mean, if you know what secret chips are, and they're not extreme, they're not painfully hard to get, but the speed chips in this game, holy fucking shit, you're probably gonna end up just, like, giving up if you don't have enough endurance to actually do that shit. So, yeah. But other than that, that's basically Metal Arms glitching a system for you right there. That's the entire game that, I mean, that I have to show for you guys. Show off all the multiplayer maps, complete the entire adventure mode. We showed those two cinematics, and I showed the one with Exavolt taking off in the rocket, because we actually lost Race to the Rocket, because hashtag scrub, guys, when it comes to rat driving. But anyways, there's one thing. There's technically one more thing that normally I would talk about in a video. However, I'm not going to do that. What I was originally going to do is I was going to talk about this article that basically discusses what a sequel of Metal Arms Glitching a System would be like. I was originally going to do that, but I don't think you guys want to sit here listening to this song while I talk to you and just ramble on about what could be in a possible Metal Arms Glitching a System. And I don't want to just, like, have to read the entire article to you guys. Like, I read off a list for beta stuff in Pikmin 3. Because, screw that. So instead, I'm going to save your time even more by posting the article in the link to the description below of this video. So you guys can read it on your own and just discover it and be surprised at what is in that article. I know I was pretty, I was really thrown for it when I read it. Because there's some interesting stuff and ideas that they would have had if had they made a sequel to Metal Arms Glitching a System. So yeah, I'll definitely post a link on that. Also, if you are interested in getting all the secret chips, I will post a link to, I'll try to find like a link to a playlist if I can do that. I don't know if you can, but I will post a link to this guy's channel called Shady Gray, who has videos on a Metal Arms LP. Maybe you want to watch his too and see what he thinks about the game. Honestly, you guys know what I think. I really love this game. It's amazing, and If you love third, if you love shooters, especially third-person shooters, you should definitely play it. It's on the Xbox Live Arcade for like only basically $10. If you have an Xbox Live, you can get it there. Or if you have a GameCube and a memory card, you can get it for like $23. Somewhere like the $20 range. It's not very cheap, and you should be able to find it relatively easy online and stuff. So yeah, but it's not like some GameCube games, like they're incredibly expensive, like fucking Donkey Kong Jungle Beat is like $100. But yeah, it's not like that. It's pretty cheap when it comes to looking for games. So yeah, if you're into that, then definitely pick it up. I highly recommend picking up this game if you liked what you saw in this LP. And yeah, I hope I got you guys to hopefully buy Metal Arms Go to the System along the way. I hope I convinced some of you guys that this game is great and that you should rate it 8 out of 8. And yeah, great game right here. And maybe if you like the game a lot, you'll go to that We Want Metal Arms 2 Facebook page, like them, and maybe even become a supporter for them. And yeah, that's really it for Metal Arms Go to the System. There's nothing really more to showcase on this in this Let's Play. I've pretty much shown everything that I've wanted to. So that is Metal Arms Go to the System. And this has been Creator438. And I hope you enjoyed this LP, because I know I enjoyed playing it for you guys. So see you guys in my next LP. By the way, I am doing two LPs alongside each other for my next projects. Yeah, they are two LPs, and I will say that my next one, we are going to in our next LP, we're going to embark on a great journey that has been probably as great as this one. But in this time, instead of saving a small city from slavery, we're saving a kingdom from destruction and darkness. So, see you guys then.